Today we are going to learn about unordered list. In our last video, we have studied ordered list. Ordered list and unordered list are the part of your current 12th standard syllabus. Okay, let us see unordered list. Unordered list is created by using UL tag. So in ordered list, it was created using UL tag. Here unordered list is created by using UL tag. Okay, in ordered list, the items were listed using LI tag. Same here. Here also the items are listed using LI tag. Now LI tag is placed inside the UL tag. Now in ordered list, the items were listed using alphabets, numbers or Roman letters. But in unordered list, the items are listed using bullets. Bullets are of three types: circle, square and disc. Okay, let us see an example how the unordered list looks like. Okay, now here you can see three figures. These are the three types of unordered list. So in the figure one, you can see the bullets are in the form of disc. Okay, in figure 2, the bullets are of type circle. In figure 3, the bullets are in the type of square. So these are three types of bullets which are used to represent unordered list. Okay. Now here, unordered list has only one attribute type. In ordered list, you all know that there were two attributes. One was chart and the other one was type. But in unordered list, we have only one attribute, that is type. In type, we are going to mention what type of bullets we are going to use. For example, three types, that is square, circle and disc. Here on the right hand side, you can see the type of bullets we are using, that is disc. Discs are nothing but filled circle. Okay, so on my left hand side, I've given the program for that. First line is doc type HTML, HTML head, and then inside body tag we are going to use UL. UL type disc. Okay, in the type attribute, you have to mention what type of bullets you are going to use. Okay, UL type is equal to disc. Then using LI, you can list down the items. For example, LI input device, close LI tag, LI CPU, close LI tag, LI output device, close the LI tag, then close the UL tag, body tag and HTML tag. I will show you one more example. Now we have used here type as disk. I will show you one more example using type as square. Now here you can see the bullet types are square. So only one change you have to make here, that is UL type is equal to square. That's it. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Now in the same way, if the bullets are in the form of circle, you will only have to write UL type is equal to circle. Okay, now let us go ahead. But in HTML5, okay, we are studying HTML5, right? In 11th standard also, we have seen HTML5 basic structure. Again in 12th, we are going to see HTML5. But HTML5 doesn't support disk, circle and square values of type attribute. In short, the type attribute is not supported by HTML5. Type attribute was supported in earlier versions of HTML. So how to represent the unordered list in HTML5? For that we have style attribute. Instead of type attribute. Okay, so you were using UL type equal to disk, right? So instead of this we will use UL style equal to, in inverted quotes, pay attention, in inverted quotes you have to write list hyphen style hyphen type colon, then whatever type you want to mention you can put it here, type here disk, then list hyphen style hyphen type square, or list hyphen style hyphen type colon circle. Okay, you can use all three types of bullets by using style attribute only in HTML5. Now you will ask, then which attribute to use, type attribute or style attribute? See, in your textbook previous version of HTML is also used, same way HTML5 is also used to write the program. So if in the question it is asked that write a program using HTML5, only in that case you will use style attribute, otherwise you have to use type attribute. Okay, only in HTML5 you use style attribute. Now let us see an example. We are going to write the code for the given output. Now look here, all the three types of bullets are used here, disk, okay, then square, and then circle. Now look how the program is written. See, on my right hand side code is given, on the right hand side output is given, on the left hand side program is written. So we will start with type equal to disk. Okay, UL type is equal to disk, then using li tag we will list t, then coffee. Now look here, inside coffee another UL type is there, that is square. So after writing coffee I will use again a UL type. Now UL type is square, I will list black coffee, cold coffee. Now look in the question, do I need the square type again? No. So hence I am closing the UL tag. UL type is equal to square over here. Okay, then again I need disk, but I already have, see, UL type equal to disk is open. So I am going to directly list the li milk. Okay, then finally I will see in the question, do I need the disk again? No. Then I will close UL tag. Then circle type is there, so I will write UL type equal to circle. In the list I will mention biscuits. Do I need further circle? No. So I will close the UL tag. Then body close and HTML close. You have to be very careful when to close the UL tag. You have to see whether you want to use, whether that type is used further or not. If it is used further, then don't close the UL tag. If it is not required further, then only you close the UL tag. Again, pay attention. Here black coffee and cold coffee are listed inside the coffee. So you have to open a separate UL tag and close that UL tag. Okay. Now let us see one more example. I hope you are understanding. Now the same program I have written using HTML5. Okay. Here see, instead of type, instead of type I am using style tag. Just I am replacing only one statement. Instead of type I am replacing it with style attribute. That's it. So I've just shown you in both the versions, okay, how to write the code. If the question says write it in HTML5, you just have to replace the type attribute with the style attribute. Okay, now let us see one more question. Now look here, in this question again two types of bullets have been used, disk and circle. In disk, what we are listing: milk, donuts, cookies and Pepto Bismol. And inside cookie, pay attention, inside cookies I will use one more UL, type is equal to circle, and list this items there. Okay, let us see the code for that. Now look here, for milk, donuts and cookies I have to use UL type is equal to this and list li milk, li donuts, li cookies. Again inside cookies I have three lists, so I will use again UL type is equal to, what is the type? Circle. So I will use UL type equal to circle and list all the three items, chocolate, sugar and peanut butter, then close the UL tag. Then finally Pepto Bismol, what is the type? Disk. Disk is already open here. Okay, so I will just list it down, Pepto Bismol, and then close the UL tag. Okay, I hope you are understanding. Then body close, HTML close. Okay, refer these two questions and write down the assignment. Okay, now see the assignment 4. Okay, assignment 4 is based on unordered list. First question, write HTML code to create following unordered list. Now pay attention here, there are two types of bullets here, circle, okay, and one is square, but square is placed inside the apples, right? So you will write, you will take UL tag, type is equal to circle, list banana, apple. Again you will take UL tag, type is equal to square, list green, red, but here you have to close the UL tag. And then finally list li tag, li pears, and then close the UL tag. So how many UL tag will come? Only 2. Okay, now let us see the next HTML. Now listen here, write a program using HTML5, they are saying. So we have seen second example, right? It is same, there is no difference. You have to write it using HTML5, that is you are going to use style attribute instead of UL type attribute. Okay, you are going to use style attribute. It is same as we have seen the second example. Then the third assignment, it is little bit different. Now pay attention, here you have to write HTML code to create the following unordered list. You can use UL type attribute. Okay, here you can see all three types of bullets are there: circle, disk, and square. So you will start with UL type equal to disk, list HTML, CSS. Now inside CSS there is one more UL type, that is circle. So you will open UL type equal to circle, list down introduction, CSS. Again inside CSS you are seeing attribute. So you are seeing two list, color and font. So that is why you will not close UL tag here. Okay, you will not close UL tag here. You continue. You will open a UL tag here. Again, you will open a UL tag here. Okay, type is equal to square, color, font. Then after this, you will close both UL. Okay, you will close both. You will close after this line. You will close both the UL tag. Then finally list JavaScript and close the final UL tag. So how many UL tag you are going to use here is 3. Okay, try to write this program. Then even if it is wrong, you just try and write. Don't copy other assignment. Okay, we can very well make out who is copying, who is writing their own. So try to write your own assignments. Okay, the final question. Write a program using HTML file. Again, you have to use style attribute to create the following unordered list. Now look here. There are two types of bullets. Disk and circle. Now how many UL tag you will use? You will start with UL type is equal to disk. List Linux. Okay, now inside Linux you can see one more UL is there. So here UL is equal to circle. Then again disk is there. So after Red Hat, again disk type is there. So you will close the UL tag. You will close UL type is equal to circle here. Then directly you can list because already UL type is equal to disk is open. So directly you can list Windows. But again you have to open UL type equal to circle, list Windows 7, Windows 10. Then can you see a disk is opening? So close this. Close UL tag here again. Okay. Then disk was already open. So you can list Mac and Android. And finally close UL type is equal to disk. So how many UL tag you need? 1, 2, and 3. Three UL tags you will need. Okay, so try to write your own assignments. Write your name and roll number in the subject and email it to us. Okay, thank you so much. The assignments should reach us within the time period given. Okay, you have to submit the assignment by tomorrow, that is Wednesday, by 6 o'clock. So if you are submitting after Wednesday, your assignments will not be accepted. Okay, I repeat, if you submit after Wednesday, your assignments will not be accepted. Okay, so try to submit it on time. Okay, thank you.